So the Mercy nerfs came out yesterday, and obviously, yeah, they are pretty dang big. I talked about them a lot yesterday, so if you want to see that, click at the card at the top of the screen right now. But I was thinking, how are these nerfs going to affect the rest of the meta in competitive and esports, everything like that? And today I wanted to talk to you guys about that. What's the meta going to become after the Mercy nerfs? Now, of course, these are just going to be mainly predictions and just kind of big speculation because I can't say exactly what's going to happen, but obviously we've seen patterns in the past and these patterns will most likely happen in the future. So I'm just going to kind of try to get you guys ready for this right now and kind of get you ready for maybe some of the heroes that you're going to be seeing more or some of the heroes that you might want to pick up. Now, I want to say in general, this is what is probably going to happen this season. Spam comp is going to be much weaker. Mercy just made that so much stronger. Junkrat getting nerfed also, it's just going to be not nearly as good anymore. And honestly, I'm not sure spam comp is still going to be prevalent in the meta. I'm sure that we're still going to see it sometimes because it's a super easy comp to pull off, especially in competitive and especially on defense, but expect it to be quite a bit weaker. Now for dive comp, I'm kind of torn on this. I feel like dive comp could come back, especially if a lot of the flankers just start to pop off a lot more. The flankers can do that more because they don't actually have to go for the ulting Mercy as much anymore because she doesn't have the reses, so that might be just enough to push them back in the limelight. But even before the Mercy buffs came in, they weren't super duper strong, so we're gonna kind of have to see with that. Deathball could also be an option that happens where you just all group up together and deathball together, a little bit different than dive with Reinhardt and a few other tanks and everything like that. I feel like that could maybe work, especially if you're having somebody like Mora as your new main tank or your new main healer on offense. That might be working for you. And if you have something like a Reaper as part of that, that could also be kind of cool. And finally, the thing that I feel like is probably going to happen at the beginning of the season is triple tank. Whenever huge changes come up, triple tank seem to just kind of become super strong because no one knows exactly what characters to play, nobody knows who's strong, and triple tank is a very easy comp to pull off. And since Anna's going to be a lot stronger now that Mercy's a lot weaker, it'll probably be a pretty prevalent meta. Also, I mean, you might not see way too much in competitive because nobody wants to play tanks, but as far as strength, that's probably going to be a good choice. So I think all three of those can be okay, but I'm guessing that either triple tank or dive is probably going to be the most prevalent again, as those really just were what was good before the Mercy buffs came out and probably will be the same after the Mercy nerfs come out. Now, in specific, I want to talk about the main characters that I feel like are going to become a lot stronger or a lot weaker or really whatever by category. So right now I'm going to talk about the supports, then the DPS, and then the tanks, and talk about how the Mercy changes affect all these different roles, because she does do a huge impact on all these roles because she was just the best support in the game, honestly. You kind of needed her in a lot of rounds, and this is what's going to kind of change. So first off on support, I'm going to say that Zenyatta is probably going to become the best support. And Zenyatta actually before the Mercy nerfs was already almost at the same win rate as Mercy. People were still popping off, getting a ton of kills. If you watch Overwatch League, Zenyatta almost always has some of the highest damage in the game. And overall, yeah, he's already a super good character. And when you get rid of the best character, you know, the second best usually climbs up to that. Now, I can't say that he's going to be picked all the time because, of course, there is still the fact that he's not a main healer, so you need somebody else to play along with him, but I feel like Zenyatta is going to be a very good character to try to pick up and to play because he was already strong in the first place, and I think he's just going to get stronger from here. Anna, I'm guessing, is probably going to be the character that takes up Mercy's slot on offense. I've been saying this quite a bit and has always been dang good on offense, honestly. And as well, as I was saying earlier, she might arise another tank meta, or she could maybe somewhat work with a deathball meta, but I feel like there's a better character that I'm going to talk about in a second that can do that. With Anna on offense, you can get out a lot of damage, charge up her ultimate really fast, get great anti-nades, but I feel like, as I said in the Mercy video yesterday, that Mercy is probably going to be a little bit better on defense still, because having that res potential and having a consistent heal on your ultimate is probably a little bit better than having Anna's just plain out outplay and damage potential. I think that's more important on offense, while the res and all these defensive abilities that Mercy has are probably going to be a bit better on defense. So that's what I feel like is going to happen with that. For Deathball, if it does happen to come up, I think that Moira is obviously going to be good with Deathball, especially on King of the Hill. Now that people can't be res back, you can just kind of go in, heal everybody at the same time, throw in a healing orb, I don't know what it's called in this game, and then just kind of whack the enemy team, because spam comp probably isn't going to be able to punish you quite as much anymore because not as many people are going to be playing spam comp. And I guess a similar type of character to Mora that we might be seeing more is Lucio. Again, a pretty offensive character that can work either with Deathball or that can work with Dive. pretty decent with either. We haven't been seeing him way too much, but I feel like he could kind of work in the same way with that. Now that, you know, you can't just be spammed on as much, you can pick this guy up, get in there, get into the enemy front line or back line, get out a lot of damage. And I think he's probably going to be an okay pick, but especially just be picked on King of the Hill, as he has essentially always been picked on. On Payload, I'm still not exactly sure if we're going to be seeing way too much Lucio. I think he is going to be more playable because you don't need to have a Mercy every single game with like a Zenyatta as your support. But I don't think we're going to see him as much as the other supports because I just don't feel like he's quite as strong as the other ones. Now to DPS, the role that everybody likes to talk about a little bit more. I don't think that every DPS is going to be affected that much. I think a decent amount of the hit scans are going to be kind of similar because they are, you know, half decent in every single meta just because how their kits work. But here are the DPS that I feel like are going to be changed the most or be hurt or helped the most. So first we have Pharah. Obviously Pharah is going to be a lot worse. Far Mercy was just the thing that kept her in the meta. It just made her viable in esports. Having the free res, being able to ult, res her again, that was just good, honestly. I mean, there's no way to really argue that. The Pharah could get picked again and again, and Mercy could just make her continue to play well. Pharah was very map dependent, so I'm not going to say she was like super good on every single map, but on the map that she was good at, she could just wreck house, but I don't feel like that's going to happen nearly as much anymore. And Pharah doesn't really work at all with any of the other supports. I mean, I guess kind of does work with Zenyatta, but not too well, so I think she's going to fall quite a bit, especially in esports where she wasn't being played way too much, even when she was really good with Mercy. Widowmaker is another esport character that I think we're going to see a decent amount less. Widowmaker, I think a lot of people have been saying, has been pretty good, mainly because of Mercy Rez. Widowmaker can play far in the back line, go for shots, and if Widowmaker fails it, well, Mercy can Rez her back up, and they can just continue to play like that. We might still see some Widowmaker, or maybe even a decent amount, because Mercy still does have that Rez every 30 seconds, but you won't have an extra Rez like you did before to make hard pushes. So you kind of have to think about, you know, should I play with the Widowmaker or will she take too many reses and be too much of a risk factor? We're going to kind of have to wait and see with that. Maybe she'll become better, but I'm guessing that she's going to be harder to justify playing because there's just not as much reses to just really go around. Junkrat's an obvious person that's going to be hurt by this. His nerfs themselves do hurt him quite a bit, I'm going to say, but especially having less Mercy to damage boost him, having less Mercy to res him in the middle of a team fight. That's going to be a real pain for him, and it's going to make so that he can be killed a lot easier by a lot of the flankers, which normally would do half decent against him. I think they're going to start doing that again, and with all the changes to Junkrat and the changes to the meta, less spam comp, I think Junkrat is, of course, going to hurt, but I still think that he is going to be at least playable, but probably a little bit more on defense than offense, which seems to be the case with a lot of characters when they kind of get nerfed, at least right now. Hanzo's somebody that we've been seeing a decent amount on offense, actually, especially in the Overwatch League. I think that we might actually see a little bit more Hanzo in the Overwatch League right now, because now if you get a cheeky one-shot, it's a lot harder for the Mercy to res that person, and especially to res a second person that you happen to kill. I think that was one of the problems that was kind of hard to pick Hanzo over, because people could just come back and a lot of your picks didn't matter way too much, but that might kind of help him. I mean, it's probably not going to make him played all the time, but he might be played at least a tiny bit more with the Mercy changes. All of the flankers, I think, are another thing to talk about. I think all of them are honestly going to be stronger. The backline can no longer be safely rezzed. If a flanker, for example, Genji, gets a Dragon Blade and kills two of the backline, Mercy used to just be able to rezz them with no trouble at all. It didn't matter. So that made them a lot weaker. But now that that's kind of out of the way, I think, yeah, they're going to be a lot stronger, obviously. And none of the flankers could really even kill Mercy because she could just fly out of the way if she was ulting in a team fight. But now, without her as much, I don't think they're going to have to worry as much because they won't really have to focus on killing the Mercy, because in a team fight, you can kind of ignore the Mercy because, I mean, she is getting that healing out, which is annoying, but there's not really the risk of a res coming out. So if you kill somebody, they're actually going to be dead for the rest of the team fight. Yeah, I think flankers are just going to kind of have a field day. I mean, they're already doing really great and they've done good in every single meta, but again, I think they're going to become good again. You know, they just kind of do that because of their mobility. And finally for DPS, I'm going to say Sombra is probably going to become quite a bit stronger. She's good against most of the supports, but can't really do just about anything against the current Mercy. I mean, she can kind of stop some of the reses, but she can just go high enough in the sky that Sombra can't really hit her, and then Sombra doesn't really have a way to kill Mercy. I think Sombra will get a little bit better as well. Again, kind of like Hanzo, not way too much better, but a decent amount better that I wanted to mention that. Now, finally to the tanks, the role that I play the most, I don't think that there's going to be too much change for a few of them, but, you know, some of them, there's going to be a lot of change, so let's just talk about that here. With D.Va, I think she's going to become stronger just a little bit, though. D.Va synergizes quite well with just about every team comp. She kind of fits in everywhere as a side tank or an off tank. But I don't feel like she synergized way too well with Mercy. I mean, I think she did okay. She could enjoy the healing, but D.Va kind of has her own self-res mechanic with that ult and with getting back into your mech. And honestly, I feel like oftentimes if you got rezzed, you just kind of immediately die again because you couldn't happen to get back in your mech if the opponents actually knew kind of what they were doing. And I think D.Va just overall synergizes a lot better with a lot of the more divey characters, especially with her damage now. So yeah, I think she's just going to get stronger. With triple tank and everything kind of coming in, and with Deathball coming in as well, I think another character I want to say that's going to get a bit stronger is Reinhardt. Especially with the spam comp getting worse, I think Reinhardt's going to get better with all those functions coming together. Reinhardt just had a problem with holding up his shield through all that spam damage. He couldn't really do anything. It just kind of became useless, honestly, because whatever, the shield's going to go down really quickly. But now, again, I think it's going to come back a little bit, and hopefully those nice Earth Shatters are going to actually do a bit. And one reason why I feel like Reinhardt is going to become quite a bit better is because I think Orisa is going to be quite a bit worse. She does work okay with triple tank, but obviously was much better with spam comp. And as well, the shields were very good with spam comp and against spam comp because, you know, you could block a lot of damage that Reinhardt couldn't really block. I mean, you could block the Reinhardt ultimate. You could block a lot of stuff that counted out Reinhardt and a lot of other characters. But if people stop playing spam comp and move more to a dive comp, what's Orisa really going to do if there's not a way to counteract all those characters? I'm not exactly sure. I think that she may be able to work in triple tank just because her damage is high enough and the shields still are useful. So you could go, I don't know exactly, like Roadhog, Moira, because that's always a really good combo. And then D.Va, that might be able to work. But other than that, I don't think we're going to see her quite as much. I think she still will be at least playable though, and will probably be a little bit weaker than Reinhardt, but maybe just right, just about where he is. And finally, for Winston, I think Winston is either going to make a big comeback as the dive tank if dive meta really does grab hold of the meta again, and then going to be played with D.Va if that happens to work, or if it's more of a tanky meta where we see like an Orisa, a D.Va, and a Roadhog, I think that might counter him just a little bit too much, and we won't be able to see him way too much in that case. It kind of depends on what a lot of people are playing. Winston has always been okay in solo queue, no matter the meta. Even in spam comp, you could play him if you knew how to pull it off, and if you can get your teammates to listen to you. So, I don't really think you should worry too much about this character, but I'm not really sure that he's going to become, you know, again, like the best tank in the game, unless dive comp becomes, again, the best comp in the game. Which I kind of hope doesn't happen. I kind of hope that we go to, I don't know, triple tank, which a lot of people hate. Or maybe something like the dive ball or death ball comp. Because we had dive right before these Mercy buffs. So I don't really want to go back to that again. But I mean, I guess that is just my own opinion. And, you know, I could kind of go for anything after like 130 days of Mercy. But anyways, that's all I'm going to say about the meta after the Mercy nerfs. These are just, of course, as always, my own personal opinion, what I think is going to happen, and kind of just basing it off of what has happened in the past. I didn't want to mention every single character in the game because I thought that would take way too long, but I mentioned the ones that I feel like are going to become the most impacted, and everyone else I feel like is going to become a little bit stronger, a little bit weaker, but probably still about the same level of playability as they were before. Maybe I'm giving some certain characters a little bit of oversight and I should be paying more attention to them. And if I do, I'll try to talk about them in the near future when they show up a lot more in competitive games. Anyways, as always, guys, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure to leave a like, comment down below what your personal opinions are, or hit that subscribe or notification button to see videos like this in the future. Anyways, as always, guys, thank you all for watching and have a wonderful day.